Breeding Ground, it's a platform. They're supporting a lot of, you know, award-winning, outspoken, unique musicians here in the mm-hmm. in New York, New York City area, you know, trying to make moves.
Right.
Grow into a big thing. So why do you think places like this are important and valuable to music and like the culture?
It's beyond important. It's beyond being valuable. It's invaluable. A point of, you know, as before we had the advent of multimedia and social media and all these ways to access music and culture and to interact with, well, you had to go out and search for it. Mm-hmm. And there were always groundbreaking, innovative thinkers. People like Barry Harris, who had the Jazz Workshop, for instance, mm-hmm. who had these places around New York or San Francisco or D.C. or Boston, where you came to town, you didn't know anybody. You could go to that place, pay $5 or something, go in and interact with, you know, like if you went to the Jazz Workshop in Manhattan in the 80s, like Ron Carter might be there playing one night. With Cedar, or, you know, just like, you know, they don't, you know, just doing, because it was Barry Harris. So, you know, there were always these areas, pockets that served as a hub for creative thinkers, from all disciplines of the art, you know, whether it's creating music, presenting music visually, there'd be painters in there and screen, you know, screenwriters and dancers. Like the first time I met Jimmy, Jimmy Slide. Here, this is not good. See your dad, boy.
See the dad died.
Right. Amen. First time I met Jimmy Slide, the great tap dancer. He was there hanging out with Barry Harris and Alan Dawson.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Like, you know, and so, like, so cut to nowadays, there are, if you're not, if you don't know what's going on, the music business seems so fragmented. Like, there's so many little pockets of scenes and all these things. But two of the most important things that I've seen, developments on the scene here in New York and through the advent of multimedia and social media have become internationally known. I've been revived music and the idea that they bring all these young people into playing music and through their connections. And it's actually through them that I came here to record with Ann Drummond and Brandy Younger. And I got to see the facility. The idea that some young people would come together, and I don't mean to accentuate young, I just mean the idea that some new thinkers, the idea was we'll create a place which is about a safe space for you to create your art first. Come in with no pressure. It's not about how many records you sell, or how many followers you have, or how many. It's about a safe space to create your music. We're going to capture it. Package it, help you promote it, with the only pressure being that it has to be good. Think about that. How many places do you go and you're just like, wow, if this was only good, yeah. Like they have everything except good. Yeah. Like in here, the occasions that I've had to be here, either as playing or listening, that's the one thing that's always, I'm like, man, these cats are really killing, right. You know, and for all of the years, that I've known a lot of musicians, you know, seeing them fly and soar here, like seeing Theo Croker and his band, yes, mm-hmm. You know what I mean? They were like on fire, you know what mm-hmm. I mean? It's just a great platform for making musicians feel comfortable, and that's why I'm a big fan and advocate and a supporter.
Well, I mean, I'm glad we're here. I've done a lot of things with.
And then I found out you were. Tariq was like, "Oh, Mark's always here."
Berkeley,
like,
you know, Berkeley fam.
Right.